So to get us started, Humana is a health and well-being organization. We're committed to driving best health outcomes for our millions of medical and specialty members. And we do that with three principles in mind. Number one, we want to deliver an easy and seamless customer experience. Number two, we want to help members achieve their best health. And we do that through 5 points of influence: primary care, social determinants of health, pharmacy, home, and behavioral health. And we power those two things with our third principle, and that is to power with integrated technology. And we have a digital health and analytics team. We have an enterprise clinical operating model. And of course, we have a strong partnership with Microsoft. So let me tell you a little bit about my role. I'm the Associate Vice President of Population Health.
Hi, everyone. My name is Sean Chandler. I'm a senior business intelligence engineer working in the enterprise analytics space. And specifically, I build Power BI tools for teams just like Dr. Wren does, and I consult on a variety of Power BI applications throughout Humana as part of the analytics platform as a service team. Melissa?
Yes, thank you, Sean. So Melissa Hooper, I'm a product implementation lead, and my role in enterprise analytics and analytics platform as a service is to bring together business teams like Dr. Renda's and our BI engineers like Sean to create wonderful user-centric designed BI reports. So in 2018, Humana undertook our, you know, beginning of our digital journey. We really formalized it by creating the vertical that Sean and I sit in called Digital Health and Analytics. And as part of the business case for Digital Health and Analytics, we did a survey with an outside consulting firm. And what we found is that our analytics professionals were using 47 disparate data sources and BI tools. Just to let that sink in for a moment, you can imagine that it's very difficult to become a master of anything if you have 47 different tools that you should be a little bit familiar with. So since 2018, our team, along with the rest of Digital Health and Analytics, has been working to standardize our data sets, standardize our reporting tools, and we're really doing that moving toward this idea of the data in our Gen 2 data lake in Azure and using Power BI specifically, but also other elements of the Power Platform so that our analytics professionals can really become experts in the Power Platform and not have to sort of spread their learning journey across multiple sources. And what we're really working toward is this data-driven culture, and that's where our team analytics platform as a service comes in. So what we're working on right now is migrating our data assets into our Gen 2 Microsoft Azure Data Lake, creating common data sets, getting access through Azure Active Directory groups, and really using the power of the Power Platform and Azure to create these citizen analysts, where we're delivering the right information at the right time to the right Humana associates to really help our members achieve their best health.
Social determinants of health are the conditions and the environments in which people live, learn, work, play, worship, and age. Essentially, they're the upstream influencers of poor health. We measure the impact of social needs or social determinants on health-related quality of life.
From a design perspective for this Power BI report, the real big challenge in front of us, of course, was taking survey data related to social determinants of health from multiple vendors and tying it all together so that in Power BI, we could tell a cohesive story about these different domains and about the screenings related to them as a whole, rather than in these data silos. And from a visual standpoint, I also wanted to highlight just some of the built-in Power BI features. And these icons were selected. And by using them in the chiclet slicer, you know, users have a very intuitive way to immediately just filter to the food insecurity screenings, or if they're interested in social support, you know, they can do this on the fly and the tool updates and they can get the information that, that they've come for. And this is something that, you know, in past tools was just not as easy to do as Power BI has made it for us. So another Power BI feature that I was eager to implement here is the integration of Power BI's bookmark features. So up here, we give the user the ability to just toggle quickly between some different commonly requested views on screenings. Obviously, you know, it starts with just screenings being a KPI that we wanted to look at month to month. But if somebody came to this and they specifically wanted to know how many screenings we were getting from each of the different source or different vendors, they can just toggle this bookmark to that view instead. Or if they want to see the screenings broken down by the different domains, that's also easily done. I'll unselect food insecurity, then they'll be able to actually see the different screenings broken down by the domains and what percentage of those screenings were positive versus negative.
And in the current times, you know, catalyzing events really gave Humana an opportunity to rethink how we were using our tools. And that's where we get into some of the digital transformation that we actually saw as a result of COVID-19. Our monthly active users since the crisis really picked up has increased from 97%. And it's interesting because of that 97%, only about 55% is directly attributable to the COVID dashboard. So what people are seeing is how quickly Humana stood up in a crisis, all of this various reporting data. They're seeing that and they're thinking, okay, if we could do that in a time of crisis, how can I move past the crisis mode and think about how I can use Power BI and the Power Platform in my daily operations?
None of us expected the COVID pandemic to occur. And when it did, you know, very quickly, we had a lot of different things we needed to understand and make some key decisions about how to respond. So having access to Power BI tools, very quickly build dashboards to visualize all of that information and to update it in real time was absolutely critical to, you know, both forming our strategy and then executing on it. And I'll add 2 points to summarize kind of what our work is around this. Number one, our goal is to create citizen data scientists to use these tools to derive actionable insights and then to make key business decisions. And that's really what the suite of Power BI tools allows us to do. And the second point is, while we never expected COVID to happen, when it did, having access to tools like Power BI really allowed us to, you know, quickly build the dashboards that we need, derive the insights that we had, form our strategy and our response to the situation. And just that ability to quickly adapt on the fly, create things, get insights, and then take action has been really, really important to our response efforts.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.